Hey everybody, Michael Lindsay here from Memphis Prime Properties, brokered by EXP Realty. Still in Lisbon? Just riding the subways around to see the different neighborhoods. There are four subway lines. We're on the green line at Roma. Just popped out. This seems to be a much more working class area, family area. See, the designs of the buildings are slightly different, but you can tell by the size. It's still much bigger than most in Europe. It's like about two families per side of the flat here. If I was comparing that to Paris, there's probably about six lined up in that same space. A little more plain. Still cool. We'll be back. Back again. The other thing to note, it's different than Paris, our last destination, is just the size of the shops. Take a look inside this restaurant here, several tables and a lot of space towards the back. Even the pharmacy. Quite large, comparatively through the window at least here, compared to what you would get in France. So, just a lot more space. In fact, there's a flower shop across the way. Also goes quite far back. In most Paris shops, it might only be about maybe 20 feet deep or so. So, and it's value for the money and just the different areas. How does that differ from what you might find around you in Memphis? These would probably be much, much bigger even, comparatively. How's it set up where you live? Let us know. Here we are in Arroyo. Just one stop down from Roma. Slightly different feel to it. Much more open. Really big roundabout. Still seems very working class though. Buildings are even a little more modern. Made with the same similar brick that you find in Old Town. It's just weird how you can go one stop over and the landscape changes so much. Hey, we're back and we're in one of the more northern suburbs of Lisboa, Odivales. We started out down here in Old Town, down by the seaport. Now we've come all the way up here. The ride here looks very suburban, lots of tall buildings and just apartments wherever you look. A lot of people on the train too. This must be from bases of that where a lot of the population lives. And if you look around, there's a lot of lights out in the distance too, so it keeps going until you get to the countryside. Maybe you'll see that better from the train. Give you a little wider angle. There's a supermarket. Much, much bigger than Paris, probably by about six times, but quite small compared to what we would have in the United States. or your typical Kroger in Memphis. Just a mere fraction. So what you get out here is a lot of repetition of the same kinds of things, coffee shops, bakeries, pharmacies, etc., etc. They're just spread out in much smaller scale versus having large centralized ones that you would have to drive to. It makes everything much more walkable since transportation is mainly public transportation or by foot. Differences from what we might be used to. It is just a little bit, you know, it's Tuesday just before Thanksgiving, and there is no Thanksgiving out in Europe here, but they do celebrate Christmas. And if you've noticed where we've been going, there's Christmas markets and such set up, very festive for the upcoming holidays. Let's see, much more laid back here, much more suburban, bigger streets, a lot more cars, more, it's densely populated but spread out. You can tell from looking up at the buildings, they're still quite large compared to other areas we've been. Thing that's also different, lots of trash cans out in public areas to put your trash. The streets are fairly clean. In the States, you know, as you might know, a lot of cities, kind of hard to find a place to throw your trash, and it winds up on the side of the road. As you can see, even out here, most of the buildings, same setup as in the urban center. Shops on the bottom, residences up top. There's your hardware store. Quite different from what you would expect from a Home Depot. We'll be back. Hey, we're back. Now we're in São Sebastião. It's kind of somewhat city center here. Halfway to the coast, halfway to the outskirts. And yet again, very different. Much more modern theme to it. Even the style of the buildings. Much more modern. A lot of air conditioners showing on these as well. A lot of the other buildings we've been looking at, not so many air conditioners out there. If you look over that way, there's a Tesla dealer. So everything continues to change no matter where you stop and get off in Lisbon. We're gonna head back towards the water next, see what the nightlife looks like, and wrap it up from there. See you in a bit. New stop, getting towards the tourist areas. We're down here now. We're gonna end up back over here by the cruise terminal. So two more stops. See a big difference in the area around. A lot of park over here too. Kind of grand boulevards, monument. Thank you. Still not necessarily the nightlife, but more of a work center. It's kind of unique over here. There's a tram to go up the hill, a little trolley car. All the way up the hill there. Feels much more upscale around here as well. All the sidewalks are this kind of stone. They paint the sidewalks white, the streets kind of a dark color. Down here we still have black top. Get into Old Town, that becomes this everywhere. Of course, the somewhat preferred mode of transportation, walking. Kind of forgot what that felt like. Drive everywhere in the States. Show you how quickly things change again. We're not but maybe 100-150 meters, so 300 to 400 or so odd feet from where that last shot was taken, and we've transferred into another section. The next train stop is just down the road that way. See, this is much more where the nightlife starts. Back that way was a lot of hotels and such. Here's where all the activity is. Again, this time of year, got a lot of Christmas markets and such popping up. It's festive. A lot of shops. More like mall type shops versus local shops. Got a Christmas market here. Lots of pastries, drinks, hot wine, hot spiced wines, souvenirs, beautiful fountain. Too bad it's not going in the summer. I'm sure that's very beautiful. Water is very blue. It shows up here. He had a spiced wine in his hand. Cheese shops. I want one of those prosciutto sandwiches there. Those look awesome. Something to point out here too, there's not a lot of landfill out here, I guess. Most of the places I've seen, including our next stop coming up, advertise a lot of recycling. Sit over here. picture with Santa. Mickey's around. To enjoy some of the Christmas music. Just a few meters away, we just left the Christmas market. We're not gonna take the train again because it's a very short walk, but we're into the mall area. More upscale stores, maybe some brands you remember or recognize. Just walk up the street a little bit. Still some local shops though, souvenir shop. Unfortunately, they don't have the street lights on. Black Friday is still a thing though. Type of music popular in Spola, which is basically Prada or amateur. So you pick up your guitar and you sing whatever you feel.
So I just came from Porto, I just arrived. So that's why that sounded a little okay. So have a nice stay here in Lisbon, because that's where I'm staying tonight. And Olá, meu nome é Clementine, vou tocar algumas músicas para vocês hoje. Eu espero que gostem, espero que tenham uma boa noite aqui em Lisboa e um bom gosto de dia. É isso.
Tower behind her is the elevator tour spot. Thank you.
It flew like a feather.